And I promise that I'll never let you down. To family and friends and the Lord up above, I will swear I'll be true to you and give you my love. Won't you give me forever to show all of the love I have here for you? And if you give me my reason for living to love you, I love you. All the love I have for you, baby. And if you give me my reason for living to love you, I love you, I do. To love you, I love you, I do. To love you, I love you.
Lord, we thank you that you're in this place and that you're well aware of our intents here today. But I pray, Lord, that we would not only be here for a man and woman coming together as husband and wife, but we would be here for the purpose of honoring you and bringing glory to your name, knowing that the depths of our souls are only satisfied as we come in contact with you and as you come and fill that empty place that we have inside of us that can only be filled by your love and your presence and who it is that you are, the God who made everything. And indeed, Lord, in making everything, you also made marriage. You crowned creation with a man and woman coming together, and here today, we honor you by seeing Stephen and Kim come together as husband and wife. Bless this time, in Jesus' name, amen. Please be seated. Who is giving this woman to be married to this man?
Her mother and I are very, very proud to give this woman to be married to Stephen Jante.
Stephen, will you have Kimberly Jean Wenrick to be your wife, to live together in the holy covenant of marriage? Will you love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her so long as you both shall live?
I will.
Kimberly, will you have Stephen Joseph Jante to be your husband, to live together in the holy covenant of marriage? Will you love him, comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him so long as you both shall live?
I will. Psalm 63, verses 1 through 5. O God, you are my God. Earnestly I seek you. My soul thirsts for you. My body longs for you in a dry and weary land where there is no water. I have seen you in the sanctuary and beheld your power and your glory. Because your love is better than life, my lips will glorify you. I will praise you as long as I live, and in your name I will lift up my hands. My soul will be satisfied as with riches of foods. With singing lips, my mouth will praise you.
Oh,
read me from Revelations 5, verses 9 through 13. And they sang a new song. You are worthy to take the scroll and to open its seals, because you were slain, and your blood you purchased man for God. From every tribe and language and people and nation, you have made them a kingdom, a priest to serve our God, and they will reign on the earth. Then I looked and heard the voice of many angels, numbering thousands and thousands, and 10,000 times 10,000. They encircled the throne and the living creatures and the elders. In a loud voice they sang, "Worthy is the Lamb who was slain to receive power and wealth and wisdom and strength and honor and glory and praise." Then I heard every creature in heaven and on earth and under the earth and on the sea and all that is in them singing, "To him who sits on the throne and to the Lamb be praise and honor and glory and power forever and ever."
Stephen Kim, I think you have succeeded in helping us to remember something very important about this service. When we talked in our time together, you and Jan and I together, we talked about how this time is a worship service. It's a marriage ceremony, yes. And you, when you walk down that aisle in a few minutes, we will walk down as husband and wife, one in God's eyes. Whereas now you stand before us having declared your intent, you have yet to say your vows. But you have succeeded in helping us to recognize that it is only because of God and only because of His goodness and His grace that we are here. And so we've come to worship. And I want to thank you for that. Everyone should know that Steve and Kim designed their ceremony, chose the music, and chose the verses that would be read, and the verse that would be on the invitation that would be sent. And the focus of that has been that we are empty, we are lost, we are alone without the great God who's made everything that there is. So thank you for that. We have come also, though, as part of that, to rejoice with you in what God's done in your lives. It's amazing to me as I look at little Stephen. I gotta stand up on the step just so I can see. You've grown so much, and I'm so grateful for the relationship that we have, but also for the relationship that you have with Christ. You have matured in your walk with Him. You have developed an understanding of ministry and of how God wants to work in people's lives that is just awesome. I've learned from it, and I want to continue to learn from it. But I say that to you because I want you to know today, I'm very proud to be able to stand here and do this ceremony and be here with you. You've chosen a beautiful bride. Certainly, we can all see that as we've watched her walk down the aisle. But many of us have also had the privilege of seeing the beauty on the inside. And we're grateful, Kim, for the woman that God has made you. And though I haven't watched you grow, I do look forward to the time of getting to know the two of you together, for the time of sharing in that relationship as well, and watching you grow. I almost don't want to use this word, but I'll use it synergistically. It's one of those big ugly words that simply means this, that the two of you will be more together than you have been as individuals. That you will accomplish more for the kingdom of God together than you would have accomplished as individuals. Things that God has put inside of you because He has designed Kim to bring those out in your life. That's pretty awesome. It's pretty exciting to think that God has designed you for each other. The aloneness that Adam felt without Eve is an aloneness that you have felt. And God has fulfilled that aloneness with the other. You know, I have often thought as I've read the scriptures that we've read today and some of the songs that we've read today, of how the world that we live in so desperately needs to know that the ache that they have inside of them can only be filled by Jesus. You know, a great philosopher of the centuries, Thomas Aquinas, said that there is a vacuum, an openness, an emptiness in the heart of every man that can only be filled by Jesus Christ. And that is what you have dedicated your lives to, letting the world know that the only thing that can fill that emptiness, that longing, that desire that we have inside of us, is Jesus. And God has sent Jesus to do that for us. We in the world, we try to fill it up with so many things. We think that we can fill it up with achievement, we can fill it up with pleasure, we can fill it up with accomplishments, and so many other things that we try to fill that emptiness up with. And all of that, God stands by and waits. And he watches patiently. And in his mercy, he continues to call to us. I love the verses where Jesus talks about how he is the living water. He says, if anybody is thirsty, let him come to me and drink. Or he's referring to himself as the bread of life, and he says, if you're hungry, I'm the bread of life. And I want to remind the two of you, as I remind each one of us, that only Jesus can fill that empty hole inside, that in your marriage, Jesus must be at the center, filling that hole, filling that emptiness. Yeah, you have an aloneness need for the other that is being filled today in a beautiful and wonderful way as you become one. But the need for Jesus remains. And though it is your longing, your desire that your lives would be a witness to others of the goodness of God and of the wonder of the cross of Christ, let me remind you also that you need to stay close to that one Jesus. You need to keep your eyes fixed on him. You need to know that when you feel alone, that he is there for you. Now I want to say also to you that in a moment when we stand up here on the platform and you exchange your vows, I want to remind you that there is that something awesome that takes place that only God can do in bringing you and making you a husband and wife. I may say some words. Now, I know you're standing here because you believe that Christ has sent you, has come to die for your sins, that God has sent Christ to die for your sin. I know that you want your friends and family to be reminded of that truth. You want all of us to realize that apart from what God has done through Christ on the cross, we are alone. We're without the one that we need the most. So we're grateful today. And we thank the Lord today for what he's done in providing the cross. Let's look to him now as we pray. Lord, as we think of the gift that you have given to Stephen and to Kim of each other, and the wonder of the union that you are completing today in their lives. We also think of the wonder of the cross. We certainly don't deserve what you have done for us. We don't deserve, Lord, at all that Jesus died in our place. We just thank you today for that wonderful gift. We knew our sin. We know our sin separates us from you, Lord. And we are alone without you. And you took the initiative by sending Christ to die for us. We glory in that. We thank you for that. We're grateful for that today. And we thank you for the many blessings that you bestow on us through the cross. Now as we go to this time of the exchange of vows, Lord, I pray that you would do that wonderful thing that you do in making Stephen Kim one. Thank you that we can participate by witnessing, by praying. Help us to be those who would encourage this new family. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Up until this time, you have been the child of your parents. Now you begin a new home. So Steve, will you repeat after me? I, Stephen, take you, Kimberly.
I, Stephen, take you, Kimberly.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better or for worse.
For better or for worse.
For richer or for poorer.
For richer or for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Until we're parted by death.
Until we're parted by death.
As God is my witness.
As God is my witness.
I give you my promise.
I give you my promise.
As for me and my house. We will serve the
Lord.
Kim, repeat after me. I, Kimberly, take you, Stephen, to be my husband, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better or for worse, for richer or for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, until we're parted by death. As God is my witness, I give you my promise. Where you go, I will go. Where you stay, I will stay. Your people will be my people. And your God, my God.
We know that there are many ways in life, and that trust is there in times like now, when things do seem to make sense. And a few months ago, I wrote this song, and it's a song that I feel reflects that trust and that desire in their lives. And I feel it reflects the journey they've embarked on thus far and their desires for their life together. I hope it speaks to you as well. Something changed in me when she came into my life, and I often wonder if this woman would be my wife. Faith has become
this ring.
With this ring.
I seal my promise.
I seal my promise.
To be your loving and faithful husband.
To be your loving and faithful husband.
As God is my witness.
As God is my witness.
Can we put this on Stephen's finger? And repeat after me. With this ring. I seal my promise. To be your loving and faithful wife. As God is my witness.
Oh, desert storm. His love endures forever. For the life that's been reborn, His love endures forever. Sing praise. Of God, we will carry on.